In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness, pour out your grace on these your servants, Bill and Devin, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated as Danny comes up to proclaim our first reading.
A reading from the book of Tobit. On their wedding night, Tobiah rose from bed and said to his wife, "Sister, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and grant us deliverance." Sarah got up, and they started to pray and beg that deliverance might be theirs. They began with these words, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Praised be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam, and you gave him his wife Eve to be his help and support. And from these two, the human race descended. You said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself.' Now, Lord, you know that I take this wife of mine not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." They said together, "Amen. Amen." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. May we proclaim our second reading.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, strive eagerly for the greatest spiritual gifts, but I shall show you a still more excellent way. If I speak in human and angelic tongues, but do not have love, I am a resounding gong or a clashing cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and comprehend all mysteries and all knowledge, if I have all faith so as to move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away everything I own, and if I hand my body over so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It is not jealous, it is not pompous, it is not inflated, it is not rude, it does not seek its own interests. It is not quick-tempered, it does not brood over injury. It does not rejoice over wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things. Love never fails. The word of the Lord.
Thanks for the
long reading.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Not everyone who says to me, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of heaven, but only the one who hears my words and does the will of my Father in heaven. Everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on rock. The rain fell, the floods came, the winds blew and buffeted the house, but it did not collapse. It had been set solidly on rock." The good news of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated. So we're gathered here today to celebrate marriage between Bill and Devin, because we as Christians, we see in the love that a husband and wife share with each other a mirror image of the love we share with our God. They're alike in so many ways. For example, we know that God's love is creative. He created us so that he can have family, so that he can love us and we love him back. And so you today are creating something here new, a new family. A family that has a chance to share in God's creative gift of bringing new life into this world. And you'll be called to watch over this family that you create, as our Heavenly Father watches over his family. We also know that God's love is covenantal. Throughout scriptures, time and time again, God makes a covenant with his people. Now, a covenant is more than just simply a contract. It's a way of defining who you are in relationship with the other. And in these covenants, God promises to be God, the one who made us, the one who loves us, the one who has a heavenly home for us. And then in return, we give back to God everything we've received, mind, body, heart, and soul. And so in the same way, the vows you will exchange are more than just simply a contract. It's a covenant where you define who you are as husband and wife for each other. And you will be called to live that promise forever, as we know that our God will never back out the promises he makes to us. Throughout our prayers, and especially in the Paul's letter to the Corinthians we just heard, we hear God's love described in so many ways. If I were to summarize the three main movements of God's love, I would say it is forgiving, accepting, and encouraging. Forgiving, in that when we sin, our God is always ready to forgive and to start anew. Accepting, even knowing our history of sin and knowing all our imperfections, God loves us now for who we are, with all our faults, and loves us deeply for who we are. And yet, as much as he loves us deeply for who we are right now, he knows what we will become when we're perfected in heaven. And so the third movement is that he encourages us to grow into that image of perfection, to become more and more holy and loving and generous and kind and merciful as our God is. And so in the same way, your love must be forgiving, accepting, and encouraging. Perhaps in the time that you've been together, you've had an opportunity to forgive each other, or has everything been hurt? There's a reluctant agreement there. No human person is perfect, and so we rely on showing mercy to each other, the same mercy our God shows us. And so you come here today knowing each other and accepting each other for who you are and loving each other deeply for who you are right now. But you will now be engaged in the project of encouraging each other to grow, to be the best person you can be, the best disciple of Christ you can be, the best husband and wife you can be, the best mother and father you can be. We also know that God's love is sacrificial. For we do not have a God who just remains up there in heaven, impassive to what's happening down here on earth. We have a God who came to earth. That in itself was a great sacrifice, letting go of his godliness to become one of us. And the life he led was a sacrificial life, taking the mission given to him by his Father and his love for us as the top priority in his life, even to the point of death. And then when he rose from that death, he continued to give of himself to us, pouring out his Spirit into our hearts so that he can always be with us. And so in the same way, your love must be sacrificial, always putting the needs of the other and your family ahead of your own needs. But it will be in that total selfless giving to each other that your two hearts will truly become one, as our God desires our hearts to be one with his. And finally, we know that God's love is communal. It's meant to be shared. God's love for us makes us better lovers of others, especially those who are in need, even those who are enemies. That's how great God's love is. And so there is more than just the promises that Devin and Phil will be making today. We, as disciples of Christ, as children of God, we all make a promise, and that is to support mutual in your love for each other, as we will be in the room of love that will overflow from your marriage back to us. And so now I ask the couple and their two witnesses to please come forward. My dear friends, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister and the community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with the sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses this love. Through a special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intentions. Phil and Devin, have you come here freely, without reservation, to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
Yes.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
Yes.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his church?
Yes.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, please face each other and join your right hands and declare your consent before God and God's church. Phil, please repeat after me. I, Philip, take you, Devin, to be my wife.
I, Philip, take you, Devin, to be my wife.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
Devin, please repeat after me. I, Devin, take you, Philip, to be my husband.
I, Devin, take you, Philip, to be my husband.
I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
May the Lord in his kindness strengthen the consent you have declared before the church and graciously bring to fulfillment his blessing within you. What God has joined, no one must divide. May I see the rings? In my defense, we did not practice it this way. May I see the ring?
Amen.
Lord, bless and sanctify your servants in their love, and let these rings, a sign of faithfulness, remind them of their love for one another. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Phil, please place Devin's ring on her finger and repeat after me. Devin, take this ring.
Devin, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
The Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
Devin, please place Phil's ring on his finger and repeat after me. Philip, take this ring.
Philip, take this ring.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
As a sign of my love and fidelity.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
And of the Holy Spirit.
And of the Holy Spirit.
If you two would now please join hands and bow your heads to pray for God's blessing. Join hands and bow your heads. Holy Father, creator of the universe, maker of man and woman in your own likeness, source of blessing for married life, we humbly pray to you for this man and woman who today are united as husband and wife in the sacrament of marriage. May your fullest blessing come upon them, so that they may together rejoice in your gift of married love and enrich your church with their children. Lord, may they both praise you when they are happy and turn to you in their sorrows. May they be glad that you help them in their work and know that you are with them in their need. May they pray to you in the community of the church and be your witnesses in the world. May they reach old age in the company of their friends and come at last to the kingdom of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. My dear friends, as we just witnessed Phil and Devin exchange promises of love for eternity with each other, let us show our support of their love at this time.
Please stand as John comes up to lead us in prayer for this couple and for the needs of the whole world.
For this bride and groom, and for their well-being as a family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For their relatives and friends, and for all who have assisted this couple, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For young people preparing to enter marriage, and for all whom the Lord is calling to another state in life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families throughout the world, and for a lasting peace among all people, let us pray for the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of our family who have passed from this world, including Chris Reed, John Reed, Maureen Reed, Laura Heiler, Phil Giles, Sandy Tomlinson, Mary and Andre Ramos, and Gertrude and Lester Pryor, all of the departed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And joining all our prayers with those of Christ who constantly intercede for us with the Father, let us pray the words that he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Let us ask for God's continued blessing on this couple. Devin and Phil, may God the Eternal Father keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and be always in your home. May your children bless you, your friends console you, and all people live in peace with you. May you always bear witness to the love of God in this world so that the afflicted and the needy will find you to be generous friends and then welcome you into the joys of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Just one announcement, the couple has opted not to have a receiving line, so they invite you all to step outside and greet them when they exit the church. The Lord be with you.
And
the Almighty God bless us all in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our celebration of the sacrament of love is now ended. Let us go in peace. Thanks be to God.
welcome to the beautiful Breakers for Devin and Phil's wedding reception. Now, before we begin, I do have one question for every single one of you in attendance. Are you guys ready to have a good time tonight or what? Make some noise out there. I love it, I love it, I love it. All right, at this time, please focus your attention back to table number 3 as I'd like to introduce you our bride's grandmother. Let's hear it for Julia Costa, ladies and gentlemen. Big round of applause for Grandma. And at this time, please focus your attention to our grand entrance as I'd like to introduce you our bride's parents. Let's hear it for Donna and Daniel Pryor. Come on, keep that round of applause going as they make their way out here. Come on. All right, big round of applause for our groom's mom, Elaine Reed, escorted by our groom's uncles, John and Ed Reed. Come on, let's hear it. Turn it up. All right, it's now time to meet your bridal party. First up, we have Annie and Dylan. Come on out. All right, keep that round of applause going for Caitlin and Anthony. All right, big round of applause for Julie and Michael. Let's hear it for Kelsey and Brian. Come on out. All right, up next is Kaylee and Justin. Come on out. Keep that round of applause going for Grace with Luke and Harrison. Watch out. All right, up next is Brianne with Mike and Patrick. All right, make some noise for Bernadette and Daniel. All right, it's time to meet the VIPs of your bridal party. Let's hear it for your maid of honor, Bridget, and your best man, Kenny. Come on out. All right, ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if you're not already doing so, please rise from your seats. And get those cell phones ready, those cameras out, because ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great honor and pleasure to introduce to you our newlyweds. Let's welcome, for the very first time, as husband and wife, the new Mr. and Mrs. Philip and Devin Reed. Come on, make some noise for our newlyweds. They just got married. It's official. Come on. Thank you.
day has come to let you go. Only happiness I will show. I'll always be here for you, you know. Nothing takes away my love and it shows. You've grown up now, things have changed. Grew some wings now, you're flying away. I'll always be here for you, you know. Nothing takes away my love and it shows. Yeah, nothing takes away my love when I let you go. 'Cause you're my baby, always will be. Stays when you go. Some years down the long, long road, if you need help with your load, I'll always be here for you, you know. Nothing takes away my love and it shows. Yeah, nothing takes away my love when I let you go.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for our friend and his very good mom, of course. So very sweet. Such a very special moment in his life. All right, ladies and gentlemen, once again, we have some very important toasts to get to this evening. So if we can have your undivided attention up here, I'm going to be passing the microphone over to the father of the bride, Mr. Daniel Pryor. So ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause once again for Dad.
First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming. And I know a lot of you came from far away, and it was really appreciated. I know Devin and Phil appreciated it. Devin knows how much I love her, and Phil, you know, he's been part of me for a while too, so I didn't look at it not losing a daughter, but gaining about 50 Irishmen, that's and woman, so it couldn't be closer, you know, I couldn't express my gratitude for everything they've done, so I just want to thank the family and Devin and Phil for being such good people. And thank you again for coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for Dad once again. Let's hear it for the father of the bride, Mr. Daniel Pryor. All right, ladies and gentlemen, if we could have your undivided attention once again up here to our sweetheart table. We're going to be passing the microphone over to your maid of honor, Bridget. So, ladies and gentlemen, once again, big round of applause. Make her feel comfortable. Bridget, take it away.
Hi, everybody. Welcome. Public speaking is not really my thing, so please just kind of bear with me. So I've met many of you while being Devin and Phil's third wheel for the past, like, 10 years. But for those of you who don't know me, I am Bridget. I'm the maid of honor, and I've been Devin's best friend for about 18 years, which is pretty wild. So we first met at soccer camp, where, to be honest, I wasn't that big of a fan of Devin, but I'm not going to really get into that story because it's just not appropriate. But after a couple years, I did warm up to her, and we eventually became attached at the hip. We started to annoy our parents because we constantly thought that we needed to be matching outfits and sharing clothes. And we spent countless nights trying to keep our whispers pretty quiet so that we didn't wake our parents up. and we spent an entire summer turning Devin's attic into a dollhouse while refusing to go outside to the beach. But at some point, this childhood friendship turned into much more, as cliche as it sounds. But Devin really did become a part of my family, and she became like my sister. So it is kind of surprising that I think I was one of the last people to really meet Phil from home. I went to PC one day, I think like our sophomore year, and it was after school had ended. My first introduction to Phil was him climbing through Devin's dorm room window. Not really sure why, but that's how he got inside. But even from the first time that I met Phil, the two of them were just so natural. So when trying to brainstorm this speech and some like cute or funny stories about the two of them, I realized that it's pretty difficult to talk about Devin and Phil because their dynamic is almost too natural and it's like too comforting. That it's hard to remember these moments because they just feel so organic. So I could go on and on with stories that have highlighted each other's best qualities, but I mean, it's too difficult to choose, and anyone that has spent time with them would understand that. So I'm sure everyone here understands what I'm saying. But I have known Devin since elementary school, and I've watched her become an elevated version of herself with Phil. It's inspiring to be around the two of them because their unconditional support and love for each other is just contagious. I don't know any other couple that embodies that more. Over the last 10 years, Devin and Phil have called many places home: Providence, Syracuse, Madison, Connecticut, and a few other stops along the way. But one thing that has never faltered has been their effortless love and support and encouragement for each other through every new endeavor. I know that I'm not one to be giving marriage advice, but I do know one thing for sure, that Devin and Phil, I know that during the rest of your lives together, you will never lose that sense of comfort and home that you radiate off of you in every situation. And I know that together you will continue to amaze and inspire not only me, but everybody here with your selfless natures and genuine warm hearts. So let's raise a glass to Devin and Phil. I don't even need to wish you the best of luck because everyone here can see that the two of you are meant to be. Sláinte.
Ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for your maid of honor, Bridget. And ladies and gentlemen, we have one more very important toast to get to. So how about it, ladies and gentlemen, big round of applause for your best man, Kenny. Kenny, my friend, take it away.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'd like to start by saying thank you to Phil and Devin for allowing me to be up here today. Maybe another round of applause for Bridget here. It's a tough act to follow. I'd say the most difficult part about making this speech today is summarizing 28 years into 5 minutes, but not to worry, I will try. For those of you that don't know me, I'm Phil's older brother, Ken. As a child, I would describe Phil as very energetic. He earned the nickname One More because no matter how many times our uncles pretended to lift him by his ears or someone did the old I've got your nose trick, Phil's response was always the same: One More. The S-Kid was another moniker that Phil went by in those days. Because of his affinity for Superman and a t-shirt with an S on it that I swear had our mother allowed, he would have worn it every day. Phil always had a smile on his face, as well as ketchup or some form of Reese's peanut butter chocolate. Along with being a happy kid, Phil was also fearless. He relished a challenge and always wanted to play with the older kids in the neighborhood. To say he was a great athlete would be an understatement. By fourth or fifth grade, Phil was playing tackle football for the Shore Blue Devils Mighty Might team as a running back. I remember one game in particular where Phil broke his arm diving into the end zone. As he was being escorted off the field, his only concern was whether or not he had scored, which he did. Phil played basketball for the first portion of his high school career and discovered track and field late by most standards, not joining the team at Christian Brothers Academy until his junior year. Phil found his calling card and was part of the national championship winning 4x55-meter shuttle relay team. He was also part of the national championship winning 4x110-meter shuttle relay team within the same year. To this day, he still holds the pentathlon record at Christian Brothers Academy with 3,311 points. Excuse me. At Providence College, Phil continued to experience a great deal of success with track and field. In his senior year, he placed second in the heptathlon at the Big East Championships, breaking the school record with 4,323 points. In the same year, Phil placed second in the decathlon at the Big East Championships, again breaking the school record with 5,835 points. I'm convinced his grit and relentlessness were what allowed him to succeed at such a high level. Qualities many would associate with our father, but undoubtedly come from our mother as well. While Phil's athletic achievements are undeniable, I know he would be the first to tell you that his greatest feat yet was when Devin said yes to being his wife. As Bridget mentioned, Phil and Devin met running track together at Providence College. I almost can't remember what things were like before Devin entered our lives because she fits so perfectly. An outstanding runner in her own right, and an even better human being. I lost my place. During the pandemic, I attempted to beat Oprah Winfrey's 1994 Marine Corps Marathon land speed record. And without any training, Devin casually jumped in for the last 13 miles and willed me to finish. While I was super excited to have beaten Oprah, I know I wouldn't have finished without Devin by my side. So thank you for being my brother's other half, and I couldn't be happier to call you sister. And as I wrap things up here, I would be remiss to mention the absence today of a very special person. Our beloved father, Chris, passed away in 2001, and while he's not here in person, his spirit remains ever present in our lives. For those of you that never had the pleasure of meeting our father, his qualities live on in my brother. He was kind, respectful, intelligent, and fiercely loyal. In writing this speech, I was reminded of a parable-like tale. Oh, excuse me. No, I'm there. In writing the speech, I was reminded of a parable-like tale that he used to love to tell Phil and I when we were children. As the story goes, in December of 1917, an Irish immigrant priest borrowed $90 from a friend and opened a shelter for young men, which eventually became the present-day site of Boys Town in Omaha, Nebraska. Shortly after opening, a boy named Howard Lewis was abandoned by his mother and sought refuge at Boys Town. Howard had polio and wore heavy braces on both legs. Walking was very difficult for him, and eventually an older boy named Reuben Granger was carrying him up and down the stairs. As time passed, Father Flanagan finally asked Reuben, "Isn't he heavy?" To which Reuben replied, "He's not heavy, he's my brother." Fortunately for me, my brother Phil is at least 50 pounds lighter than I am. I'm not sure our father saw that one coming. But in all seriousness, the phrase, "he's not heavy, he's my brother," has been a guiding principle our entire lives. About a year ago, Phil convinced me to quit my job in finance and join him at Davenport Associates, turn page, where I've never been happier in my entire life. I've certainly been incredibly heavy for Phil over the course of the last year, physically and metaphorically, but he's never made me feel that way. He's the best business partner, colleague, friend I've ever had in my life, so thank you. And while this story from Boys Town always seemed particularly relevant for Phil and I know the intent of its practicality extends beyond just the two of us. Throughout the ups and downs, the good, the bad, and the ugly, family has always been a constant. Family has never been heavy. So as the two of you move forward on this journey together, may you always remember to pick one another up when the time calls for it, no matter the weight of the situation. I love you both and wish you a lifetime of good health and happiness. And with that, I'd like everyone just to raise a glass. Cheers to Phil and Devin.
Devin, take a few steps to your left. Yeah, do a little, couple, actually, no, go to your right. There we go. Devin, just take a look behind you. Make sure that looks good. Is that good? We even got Grandma out there. All right, watch the chandelier. Devin, here we go. On the count of three. One, two, three, toss it. Watch out. With the ricochet. I love it. Great job.
and everybody's shaking, and we're staying alive, staying alive.